The next flow that we want to talk about, again a simple flow, is the source. So what we are going to assume is that there is a point in a certain location through which fluid actually is emanating in the radial direction and spreading out. So the way we would like to define a source is that streamlines emanate from a point radially outwards. Okay. And the velocity along each streamline varies inversely with R. So the suggestion is that we can say Vr is essentially K by R and V theta is 0. So we are going to use the polar coordinates to describe this flow. Okay. Alright. So let's determine the velocity potential and the stream function for this kind of a flow. So let's first check the divergence of V. Is this an incompressible flow? So divergence of V is going to tell us 1 by R del by del R of R Vr plus 1 by R del V theta by del theta plus del Vz by del Z, but this, you know, is the Z direction where we are not so much interested, we are only interested in the R theta plane. So if I plug this in, I would get 1 by R del by del R of, so R times Vr gives me simply a K, plus 1 by R times del V theta by del theta, which is 0 actually, because my V theta is 0. Okay. And it turns out this is actually 0 everywhere. But a problem at R equal to 0. In fact, this term would give me a problem at R equal to 0. So even though this term is, you know, K is a constant, so del K del R is 0. But because it is divided by R, so as I approach the origin, divergence of V is a problem at the origin. So therefore, this is some kind of a singularity. So singularity with respect to mass balance. As you know, the divergence of V equal to 0 is the equation of continuity which enforces the mass balance. And what we are saying is that there is a problem at origin, but other than that, things are fine. In fact, if we wanted to draw this flow, the flow looks something like this. So this is my origin, and the streamlines are actually going radially outward. So these are my streamlines. Okay. So at each point, if I draw a velocity vector, then I see that only the radial speed is non-zero. There is no component along the theta direction. So this is the origin, of course. Okay. Now let me say that Q is the flow rate per unit depth along Z. So you can imagine that there is some kind of a pipe that emanates out of the plane of the back blackboard, and it is squirting fluid in the radial direction. Okay, so we are trying to figure out what is the volume flow rate at a certain location. So for that I would make a ring, okay, to calculate the volume flow rate. So this I could simply write as integral between 0 to 2 pi. So I go around this and then simply do Vr dot times r d theta. Okay. So if this is r, then I am just taking this integral over the entire theta, and this therefore would give me Vr is k by r times r d theta from 0 to 2 pi. And this would give us 2 pi k. So the value of the constant is essentially q over 2 pi. Okay. And q is referred to as the strength of the sink, sorry, of the source. Okay. So the physical description is the following, that there is some fluid that is going out radially, but if I took different circles of radii r, then the speed is changing with 1 over r, such that the volume flow rate is constant at all these rings. Okay, so that is why this equation, this flow satisfies the continuity equation, and there is no loss or gain of mass. Okay, so I could now say that my Vr is defined as k over r. I can substitute for k as q over 2 pi. And my v theta is 0. So that's the description of my flow. For q greater than 0, I have what is called as a source. But if q is less than 0, then I get what is called a sink. And a sink would be something like this. So all the flow is going radially inward. So this is a sink. Okay. All right. So we can now try to find out what is the velocity potential for such a flow. So we know del phi by del r is actually Vr. And that is given as simply q by 2 pi r, whereas del phi by del theta 1 by r is v theta, which in this case is 0. So I can integrate these two equations and find out phi in terms of r and theta. So if I do that, then I will be able to see that phi is simply given as q by 2 pi natural log of r plus some constant c. I can actually take c equal to 0 and then my phi simply becomes q by 2 pi natural log of r. Okay. What about my stream function? The stream function can again be done in the following manner. So if I do 1 by r del psi by del theta, that is my Vr, and minus del psi by del r would give me V theta. I know my Vr is simply q by 2 pi r, and this of course is 0. Again, I can integrate these two equations and get a psi out of it, put the constant as 0, and that would turn out to be q over 2 pi times a theta. So if I had to draw the streamlines are simply psi equal to constant. And the equipotential lines they are given as phi equal to constant. So if I had to draw them, the lines given in these dark white color, they are the stream lines, and if I had to draw the equipotential lines, these would be just concentric circles. So these are equipotential lines. And the streamlines, they are emanating outwards. If I had a sink flow, now my streamlines are going towards the origin, and my equipotential lines would be again these circles. So these are equipotential lines, and as I said before, the streamlines would have a direction, but normally we don't put direction on the equipotential lines. Great. Let's now try to figure out what is the circulation for this flow. The circulation for this flow is given as gamma, and that would be an integral over a curve C, V dot ds. Okay. So I can again take a circle. So I could take any one of these circles. So for example, I could take this one and call it the curve C. I'll do an integral over this circle. And this I can therefore write as in two components. Essentially, a component over Vr and V theta. So this would be given as simply q over 2 pi r. But then this is a radial component, so this has a direction Er. But the ds is in the tangential direction, so this I would write as r d theta e theta. Right? So that's my circulation because of the special curve that I have chosen. So the velocity is in the radial direction, and my curve, this infinitesimal ds, is in the tangential direction. Now Er and E theta are orthogonal, and therefore this integral actually goes to 0, and there is no problem with the singularity also because these r's they cancel out. So what we have been able to show is that for a source or a sink, the circulation is 0, and therefore this flow is definitely irrotational. You can further check it with curl of velocity. Okay, I am not doing that here, but you certainly can do that, and what you will find is that this would also be 0 everywhere, and you get an irrotational flow. Okay, so what have we learnt? What we have said is that as far as a source or a sink is concerned, this is a building block of a potential flow,
it is irrotational everywhere. Unfortunately, it has a singularity at r equal to 0. And the singularity is because you are trying to push in enormous amount of flow through a point r equal to 0. Remember, q is finite. So we have a situation, so in the case of a sink, all this flow comes in and the volume flow rate through any of these circles is q. And when it comes to a point at the origin, all this is going through through a certain point, and therefore the mass balance seems to break down. So it's a singularity in that sense. So due to mass balance. It would be very interesting to look at what happens to the pressure. Okay. Once we have calculated the speed of the flow everywhere, now let us apply the Bernoulli's equation and calculate the pressure.